Hi guys, I'm Joa. Thank you for watching this video. So I'm in a lake on the boat. You can see here. And obviously, with such good scenes, like a scenic surrounding, I should talk about Valkyrie Crusade. Let's look at this side of the pond, or the lake. You can see here lots of seaweed or something, right? So I want to talk about the current event. I think it's called Bounty something or Hunting something. Hunting a bounty or whatever, I don't care. But so what I want to say is that this event is quite interesting. I like the grinding aspect of it. It's slightly more modern, I would say, compared to previous events and compared to other, for example, Japanese CCG games. But the requirements, I'm catching a bit of wind, so the sound quality might be quite bad. But the requirements is quite insane. They are equal to 800 or 80,000 those bounty reward thingies, and it's really grindy. Okay, it takes a lot of time. I've been playing a lot because it's fun, and I like how Empress Cleopatra is quite challenging. Sorry, I haven't been speaking English in a while, so but it's very bad for free players, and because Cleopatra is so hard to beat. And the normal arc witches are extremely have an extremely low payoff. So that's something they need to really think about. I mean, I've been burning my shoes, I've been having fun because I have a huge stockpile of shoes, and my team is strong enough to take on Empress Cleopatra, especially after certain modifications, which I'll probably make a video about. But yeah, I see people in my guild, they are really frustrated. Well, my alliance are really frustrated because the arc witch is so strong, and the weaker arc witches are extremely like meh in terms of rewards. I mean, like seriously, two bounties for the weakest one? Two? What can players hope to accomplish by getting two? Right? It feels like an insult, to be honest. So they should really have a good think about it. Maybe they're accumulating data if you wanna give them kind of a leeway or credit or benefit of the doubt. Right, but that mountain's really good. So I said I was going up a snowy mountain, but this side of this mountain has no snow, so we can't really see it. But yeah, that's what I think of the event. I was really excited, and I guess I'll do a really short card review, so if I can go back to the hotel and upload, I can. So it's just Empress Cleopatra. I'm not sure how good that card is, to be honest. But she feels like an interesting card to have, but the price is crazy. So the consideration is, you know, 80 Ultimate Summon Tickets or 1 GUR Empress Cleopatra. I'm not really sure. I guess if you really achieve enough bounties to get Empress Cleopatra, but for some reason your team isn't very strong, I would probably go for Ultimate Summon Tickets and hope you get the URs that are useful and all that, right? But that's just my thought. And having Empress Cleopatra would be quite fun. I can envision her quite useful in Legendary Arquitch fights. For example, when the Legendary Arquitch, when you're in awakened state and the boat is about to sink. Two attacks per awakened attack, and then it's gonna be great. And then there are people commenting on another boat asking, what the hell is that guy doing? Well, I guess I should stop now. So, alright, thank you for watching this weird review video, and that's it for my video. Thank you very much for